Hello and welcome to our quarterly outlook. Today with Valentin, we will discuss our economic scenario and our portfolio positioning. Global growth will continue to weaken, but will remain above its potential in 2021 and 2022. The manufacturing cycle will be affected by global supply chain issues, but the rise in producer prices, the rush to rebuild inventories, and pressure in the freight markets should ease next year as the global economy fully reopens and labor force participation rates increase. Developed countries, and particularly the US, will be the world's key growth driver. Emerging market countries are struggling with high inflation and monetary policies will continue to tighten. In China, the outlook remains gloomy. The slowdown is more pronounced due to power cuts and the zero tolerance approach to COVID. Activity in the real estate market will continue to slow with restrictions to limit debt levels and financial difficulties of property developers. Therefore, China's central bank is likely to take a more accommodative stance. But its impact will be limited by government's regulations to control financial risk and by reforms intended to increase social equality and make growth more sustainable. In developed countries, monetary policy normalization is looming since inflation expectations have been revised up. The Federal Reserve will begin tapering before year-end and will end its purchases in the middle of next year. A first rate hike is likely to come by the end of 2022, followed by three hikes in 2023. The Bank of England is likely to announce two rate hikes in 2022, starting before the second half of the year, the exception being the ECB that maintains its dovish stance.
As Marie just explained, the normalization of monetary policies in the US will have major implications on our asset allocation. Higher real interest rates and slower economic growth mean lower equity valuation and a stronger US dollar. In our strategy, we decrease further our allocation to sovereign bonds in all currencies as we expect rates to move higher in the fourth quarter. While the ECB remains accommodative, rates should also increase in Europe in sympathy with the US. On credit, we remain invested, but the upside will be limited in the fourth quarter. Spreads are tight and the risk-adjusted return is poor. However, we do not expect spreads to widen as long as growth remains above potential. Investment-grade bonds indices also have high exposure to the financial sector, which should benefit from higher rates. Higher real interest rates and slower growth are negative for equity markets, specifically for expensive stocks and consumer cyclical goods. Over the previous months, we continued to rebalance our sector allocation to reduce the exposure to some cyclical sectors, and we sold emerging market equities. Even though valuations have declined in China, we think that the equity risk premium will stay high given the level of uncertainties. We also increased our allocation to financials and to sectors that continue to benefit from remaining pent-up demand in the economy. These stocks have lower valuations and their earnings are more resilient in a slower growth environment. Finally, we continue to expect a stronger US dollar, particularly against low-yielding and safe haven currencies such as the Swiss franc, the yen, and the euro. Thank you for your attention, and I hope to see you soon.
Yeah.